Week 3 of our subject, electrical machines. Okay, this is still a review of our previous lessons, which is significant to our study of electrical machines. This is all about Kirchhoff's laws. Okay, there are two basic Kirchhoff's laws that can be applied to any direct or alternating current circuits. One is Kirchhoff's current law, or simply known as KCL. This states that summation of all the currents leaving and entering a junction is equal to zero. In equation, that is the summation of all the currents equals zero. In using Kirchhoff's current law, we consider a node or a junction where three or more currents passes through. Currents may enter or may leave this junction. Okay. This is current I1, this is current I2, current I3, current I4. Okay. If we assume that those currents entering a point to be positive, and all currents leaving the point or node to be negative, okay, we can produce equation for these currents. Okay, for I1, since this is entering the given node, that is positive, and I2 is negative, then I3 is positive, then I4 is negative, then equating this to zero, we have this equation. Then combining similar signs, I1 and I2, I3, it's are both positive, then I2 and I4, then it transpose to the other side. Okay, we can state Kirchhoff's current law that the summation of all the currents entering must be equal to the summation of all the currents leaving a junction. Okay. This Kirchhoff's laws obeys the law of conservation of energy, that energy is neither created nor destroyed, but is only transformed to other form. Okay. That is, energy input must be equal to energy output. That's the basic of conservation of energy. Okay, the second law is the Kirchhoff's voltage law. You can simply write this as KVL. States that the summation of all the voltages around the closed loop is equal to zero. That is, EMFs and IR must be equal to zero. This is only applicable to any closed loop. These are the two sources of voltages in any circuit. One is the active one, and then the other is the passive one. EMF, this is an electrical pressure that causes electrons to flow. Kaya this is an active element. And IR is the voltage due to the current flowing through the given resistive load. This is passive since it is this element only receives current, thus producing voltage drop. Okay. Then, just like for current, we have to assign sign for EMF that we can use in applying Kirchhoff's voltage law. Same convention for EMF. Laging tatandaan, being an active element, this is the source of electric current. Okay. For conventional current direction, the current comes out of the positive terminal, then return back to the negative terminal. Sa pag-assign ng value for EMF, if we are to trace the direction in any direction, either clockwise or counterclockwise, kung ito yung direction ng tracing natin, okay, kung ang direction ng tracing ay dumaan sa negative at lumabas sa positive, we will be producing a positive E. Okay, kung saang terminal lumabas, yun yung magiging sign ng voltage. Kaya sa parehas na voltage source, kung babaliktarin lang natin yung direction ng tracing, since the tracing comes out of the negative terminal, kaya this will produce a negative E. Okay. Hindi natin dito tinitingnan yung direction ng current since ito ay active element. Okay, ang titingnan lang natin ay itong terminals na ito kung saan pumasok or lumabas yung direction ng tracing. Okay, for IR, it's either a drop or a rise. Since this is a passive element, ito yung resistance, importante na alam natin yung direction ng current. Kaya once na trinace natin siya, either in a clockwise or counterclockwise direction, malalaman natin yung direction ng yung polarity ng voltage IR. Okay, when tracing a resistance, okay, if the direction of the tracing is with the direction of the current, or kung the same in direction nila, this produces a voltage drop. That is IR, negative IR. Okay, kung ang direction ng tracing is against the direction of the current, this is a positive IR, a voltage rise. Okay, yan. Yan lang yung dalawang convention na kinoconsider natin para sa sign ng EMF and IR. Pag ina-apply natin yung Kirchhoff's law sa any given DC at DC network. Yan. For EMF, kung saan terminal lumabas, yun yung magiging sign. Okay. Yung direction ng tracing ay irrelevant sa sign ng EMF. Pwede mo siyang i-trace sa clockwise or counterclockwise direction, then but still hindi magbabago yung sign ng E. Okay. Ang magpapabago lang sa sign ng EMF ay yung change sa polarity. Kung binaligtad mo yan, magbabago yung sign niya. Okay. Ganun din sa IR. Okay. Tinitingnan lang natin ay yung direction naman ng current at yung direction ng tracing. Kapag same yung direction ng tracing at ng current, negative yung I times R. Then yung kung against naman yung direction ng tracing at ng current, positive naman yung I and R. Kinoconsider natin direction dito ay ng current ay yung conventional current direction na yung current ay nanggagaling sa higher potential ng voltage source. Simpleng application netong Kirchhoff's laws ay sa series and parallel circuit. Okay. Given this series circuit with the applied voltage E and with three resistances in series, okay, ito yung magiging current flow. The voltage across each element is V1, V2, and V3. Since this is a closed loop, we can apply Kirchhoff's voltage law. Tracing this in a clockwise direction, starting with the EMF, from negative to positive, comes out of the positive terminal, kaya we will have a positive EMF E. Then for IR1, IR2, IR3, we have negative voltages since yung direction ng tracing natin ay the same as direction ng current, kaya negative IR1 minus IR2 minus IR3, and the sum must be equal to 0, where negative IR1 is the same as V1, then IR2 is V2, and IR3 is V3. Okay, we have this first Kirchhoff's voltage law. For series circuit, the total voltage applied equals the sum of all the voltage drops across its resistor. Okay, and this is simple application of Kirchhoff's voltage law. Okay, application of Kirchhoff's current law. Okay. Okay, with the same applied voltage VT, we have R1, R2, R3. Okay, same voltage is being applied here across its resistor. Okay. The branch currents I1, I2, I3 which is part of the total current coming from the main source. Okay, this circuit is the same as this circuit. Yung sa upper part na ito ng mga terminals, pwedeng pagsama-samahin as a common junction. Ganun din yung terminal sa baba. Okay. Common junction B. Okay. Kaya ito pa rin yung total current. Then individual or branch currents ay I1, I2, and I3. Okay, if we apply KCL at A, I total is positive, this since this entering the point A, then minus I1, minus I2, minus I3, these are currents leaving this junction A but entering point B. Kaya pag sinulat natin, I total is I1 plus I2 plus I3. Then if we apply KCL at point B, negative yung I1, negative yung I2, positive yung I1, positive yung I2, positive yung I3, and yung total is negative. Okay, the same equation na ang na-produce natin when we apply KCL at point A. That is, the sum of the currents entering a point must equal the sum of all the currents leaving the point. Kaya, either we assume A or B, isa lang sa kanila ang pwede mo nang i-assume para makapag-produce ka ng current equation. Okay? And this is Kirchhoff's laws. Na magagamit natin sa pag-aaral natin ng electrical machines. Okay, when we consider the equivalent circuit of different types of DC generator. Okay, this is our lesson for today, and you will be solving activity regarding Kirchhoff's laws after neto.